Okay, so in this tutorial, I will show you how to make this close effect. It's not real close, it's not a close simulation or soft body simulation. It's a fake, but you see, it's looking good. So I will show you how to do that. It's very easy. So we go to Cinema 4D. We just start with a plane. So drop a plane. Add like 150 segment like that. So if I display, you got that, you see a lot of subdivision. This is fine. I will drop the plane like 250 height like that in Y. I will display normal shading, Goro shading like that. So to do this effect, you have to add a jiggle deformer. So not a lot of people use it this way, but you can add forces here. So because for the moment, well, it's doing nothing, as you can see, but you can add forces here to make the jiggle deformer work. So go to object. We don't need spring for here. So I put it on zero. And on force, I can add simulate particle and choose turbulence. For the turbulence, we want a little bit more strength, but we want tiny movement. You see a small movement. So I will, the scale, I will put it to 10 as well. And let's see what, drag the turbulence inside here, inside the forces. And now if you press play, you see, we've got our effect. So that the small ripple, you see, small little ripple everywhere. But we want as well a bigger movement, you see, like this big wave, big movement on top of that. You see, there is a little ripple, but there are big movements like that. So we will do that as well. So to do that, it's very simple. It's just another noise on top of that. So duplicate this one, I will stop, Alt Control, duplicate this one, and for this one, just increase the scale, and maybe reduce the strength, and now add it to the list here. And now if we press play, we've got both. We've got small one and little one. I'll just will increase the timeline, as you can see. So this is fine. We can add a smooth under that. So go there, smoothing, drop it down. So the animation, you see, it's more smoother now. But we don't want really smooth. I prefer use relax. And for relax, you see all the settings are gray because you have to set up a first frame. Click on initialize, and now you can play with the setting. So put swiftness to zero, add maybe 100 iteration. And if I press play, it's longer to calculate, but as you can see the result, it's more look like close now. So this is fine. We can add some thickness because for the moment it's just a plane. So we can use simulate, close surface, drop the plane inside it, subdivision we don't need, but thickness add one. So now as you can see there is a little thickness here, and you can put all that inside a subdivision surface like that. Drop everything. You see now we've got a cool border like that. I will go to subdivision surface and put one and one. So that is it. Now we can just make a little scene, so drop a floor, create material, drop it on the floor, go inside the material, and for color, you can put 10, here 10, and here like 90. And it's okay for the floor, add background, drop the same material, right click on the floor, Cinema 4D tag, compositing, and check on compositing background. We can add a light, so click here, add PBR light. Movie Der I will make the light the same height of the plane, so it's a 250. So here 250 and minus 500, and I will make it bigger. And make it like blue like that. And we had a second light on a headlight. You see top light here. So make another one. PBR light. Make it bigger this way. Turn it 90 degrees this way. And move it up. You see, maybe like that. I will make it not that strong. So go to light, general. And I intensity, I will make it less, like that, and make it orange, maybe. Let's see what we have. You see, it's really looking close. We can add close material on this, so I go to Content Library, I got that. I will drop it, this material, on the subdivision surface, here, and you see, I've got strip line here. I will make it smaller, so I will have more strip. So let's say 10 and 10. You see now the line. It's more looking like a clothes. So if you want to use the same material as me, I will show you a website. So go there, and you see the seat is a C4D center. And you've got a lot of category, you see bricks, candy, concrete, fabrics, and inside fabrics, you will find this one, and this is the one that I actually use, but you see you've got other, lot of other good, very good material here. So check it, it's a C4D center, go to material library then, and you have all that, all this material for, you see concrete, ground, metal and so on. So check it. I will go back to Cinema 4D. So we've got that, but maybe you don't want let's say red material like that. So you can go there, and for the color go to click here on texture little arrow and choose layer. Go inside the layer, go to effect, hue and saturation, and add maybe 25, so you've got like a gold. And if you render that, you see we still have like a red reflection like we had before. So you want to go to color, right click, copy this texture, and go back to reflectance, and you can see it's the same. So right click and paste. So now, we got a good texture. So I will go to, and so if you want to render maybe this frame, you want this frame for rendering. If you press render now, you see you've got a flat plane. It's not working. So if you want to render that, if you want to render animation, it's not a problem because it will start from a start plane and then it will make the animation, it will work. But if you want to like just to render the frame you like, you know, maybe this one, so that or the 10 one, you see, frame 11 like that. If you want just render that, you have to go to, just to make sure, you go to smoothing, go back to first frame, because if you change some value, so to make sure you can go back to smoothing, go to first frame and tip again initialize to make sure, and now go to jiggle, go to cache, and I will, well, 50 frame, it's okay, I will cache everything, so click on cache. So now you see it's calculating for the cache, so I will wait for that until it go to 50. Okay, the cash is done, so now you can just move here, you see, and maybe you like this frame. So we will look from there, maybe. Go there, and now if I render, you see, I got my clothes. So, like I said, it's not a real clothes, but as you can see, it's really looking like a clothes. So, that's all for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed. We are almost 1000 on my YouTube channel, as you can see. Almost near 1000 followers, so that's fine. So, don't forget to like and subscribe my video, it's helped me for the channel. And thanks for watching, and I see you in the next tutorial.